Now we are discussing the frequency division multiplexing. We already know that multiplexing means combining the different signals together to a one. And under the multiplexing, in the analog technique, we are having the first one, which is the FDM. FDM stands for frequency division multiplexing. So as the FDM comes under the analog technique, so we can say that frequency division is the analog technique. Let's focus on the diagram. Here you can see that there are three telephones. Let us suppose that this is the telephone 1, telephone 2, and telephone 3. Now they are working on the different frequency when they are talking. Obviously the analog signals are coming. So there are three analog signals which are coming here. So this is the first analog signal. This is the another analog signals. So different frequency are there. So these three frequencies are going to the multiplexer. Now the MUX is the multiplexer which is going to combine these three frequency. Now you know that there is a single line. This is the complete link, and through this link or the line we are sending the three data together. So these three frequencies are coming together. Now hypothetically this link, this is the complete link, and this complete link is divided into the three different channels. Because there are three devices, that's why this complete link is divided into the different channel. Let us suppose this is a channel 1, it is a channel 2, and this one is the channel 3. So this is the hypothetical division, and inside these three channels the three frequencies of telephone 1, 2 and 3, they are moving. So these three frequencies are moving like this, and they will reach to the demultiplexer, and demultiplexer will again just bifurcate them to the different telephones. So this is how the frequency division multiplexing is working. And one important thing we have learned here is the link is divided into the different channels. So first thing we must know about the frequency division multiplexing is that, let us suppose that this is the first channel. Now telephone 1 is sending some signal, again telephone 2 and telephone 3. Now their bandwidth and the bandwidth of link, that should obviously be high. Because let us suppose that the bandwidth of first channel is 10. I am assuming that this one is 10 bandwidth. This is the 10. Again this one is a 10. Maybe I am assuming into 10 Mbps or something. So that is the bandwidth. Now to carry these signals together, 10 plus 10 plus 10, that means minimum 30. So this link bandwidth should be minimum 30. So that it can send all three signals together. Means if I talk about this particular thing, this is the complete link. Now that one should be minimum 30. 30 or more than that, it can be 40, 50, so minimum 30. So we can say that the bandwidth of link is greater than combined bandwidth of signal. So if the signals are of 10 Mbps, then obviously the channel capacity should be more than 30, so that it can carry the three signals. Now, next thing about the frequency division multiplexing is that their bandwidth is divided into small bandwidth and they act as the separate channel. Now the meaning of this line is that bandwidth of complete link is divided into small bandwidth. So this is the 30 bandwidth of complete link. Link means I am talking about this complete link which is passing through from one source to another destination. Now this 30 is divided into small parts separate. So let us suppose that this is 10 I am giving here, this 10 I am giving here, and this 10 I am giving here. And these 10 small bandwidth are acting like the channels. So this 10 I am assuming is the channel 1, and next 10 is channel 2, next 10 is channel 3. Now this particular channel 1 is going to take out the data of telephone 1, then channel 2 is going to take the data of telephone 2, and channel 3 is going to take the data of telephone 3. That's why it is saying the complete bandwidth 30 is divided into small bandwidth 10, 10, 10, and they are acting like the separate channels 1, 2, 3. So what we have learned here through this diagram, that first of all, the frequency division multiplexing is the analog technique. Second thing, the channel capacity through which we are sending the multiplex data, that channel capacity should be greater than the combined devices data. And next one, that channel capacity is divided hypothetically into small parts, and they act like the separate channels. This is the hypothetical division. Actually, it is not divided, but we are assuming that this is divided like this. So that is how the frequency division multiplexing work. So this one is a detailed diagram of the telephone which we have discussed. Now you know that this was the telephone 1, this was the telephone 2, and this is the telephone 3. Now they are sending the signals on the different frequency. Let us suppose that this is the frequency 1, frequency 2, and frequency 3. These are the analog frequency which they are sending. Now this frequency is given to the modulator. So these modulators are having these frequency and they are going to modulate them. Modulator is required because whatever we speak is at very small pace. Now to send it through the medium, the modulator increase its frequency, then send it, then again decrease back. So they are increased. Now these are the updated frequency which are here. So the frequency 1 is updated with this one, frequency 2 and frequency 3. Now they are combined here. So they are combined here. So this is the complete multiplexer. Now this is the composite signal which is sending through the first part. So this was the sender where we are having the multiplexer also. So this signal we are sending. Now this signal is received to the receiver end. So here at the receiver side, we are having the demultiplexer. Now first of all, the demultiplexer is going to divide them into different frequencies, and filter is applied. Filter is going to filter them into the different frequency. So frequency 1, 2 and 3. Now demodulators are applied so that they can convert back to their original form. So here the demodulators are given on frequency 1, 2 and 3. And these are the original frequency which we are having, F1, F2 and F3. So these are the destination telephones on which the data is going. So if the three telephones are working together, they are speaking together. So their data is merged, sent through a single medium to the other people, and other people which are three can hear that data. So that is the complete purpose of the frequency division multiplexing. So the signal which is combining of the different signal is called the composite signal. So this one is the composite signal. Now through the medium, the composite signal is only sent. Now this combined signal is again divided back through the multiplexer. So we can say that each sending device modulate the different carrier frequency which is combined into composite signal for transmitting. Now the meaning of this line is that each sending device, that means there are three devices, telephone 1, 2 and 3, they are going to modulate the different carrier frequency. So these are the three frequencies. This is the frequency 1, frequency 2, which are modulated, and frequency 3. So these three frequency, which is combined into the composite signal. So this one is the composite signal, means all these frequencies are combined to one frequency, and they are for the sending. Now this frequency is going to send to the receiver side, and receiver side is getting this frequency, and this composite frequency or the signal is again bifurcated back to the frequencies for the different devices, and this is done using the demultiplexer. So that is how the frequency division multiplexing is going to work. There is one more example by which we can understand the frequency division multiplexing. Let us suppose that there are three devices, which is D1, D2, D3 and D4. Now these three devices are sending the different kilohertz of the frequency, and we know that the frequency can be of any of the range. So we are assuming that these three frequency are the analog signals, and these three analog signals all are of 250 kilohertz. So if everybody is sending the data frequency of 250 kilohertz and they are going to the multiplexer, so after frequency division multiplexing, now the link which we are having, so this particular link which we are having through which the data is passing, now this will be of 1 megahertz, because we know that 250 plus 250 plus 250 plus 250, 4 times 250 becoming the 1 megahertz. So there the carrier frequency is the combination of the frequency of all the devices. That's why this 1 megahertz is combining all the frequencies of all the devices. Now we are discussing the guard band. Now we are discussing the guard band into the FDM. Now we already know that there are three devices. Let us suppose that three telephones are there, and these three telephones are sending the data, and they are combined, and these data frequency are traveling through the channel 1, 2 and 3. So that we have discussed in the FDM. Now these two channels, let us suppose that this is the first channel, and this one is the channel 2, and this one is the channel 3. Now these two channels are sending the three different frequencies, and these three frequencies should not merge together. That's why there is some kind of gap is given. So some gap is given here. So these gaps which we are giving is called the guard band. Now let us suppose that we are taking the same example here. There are some certain devices. Let us suppose that this is device 1 which is sending some data. This is device 2. This is device 3, device 4 and device 5. So these are the 5 devices which are going to send the data, and all the data frequency is of 100 kilohertz. So 100 kilohertz of the frequency they are producing. Now that means we need how many channels? In a complete link, in a complete line, we know that this one is the complete link. And in this complete link, we are having how many channels? Channel 1, 2 and 3. Similarly, in a complete link, that link will be of how much? 540 kilohertz, because these are the five devices, all are just having the different data, so they are combining. Now this complete frequency, we are assuming that this is the complete link, and this complete link capacity is 540. That means there are different channels. This is channel 1, channel 2, channel 3, channel 4 and channel 5. Just like in a link we are having different channels, similarly here in a link we are having different channels. So channel 1 is sending the frequency of D1, channel 2 for D2, channel 3 for D3, channel 4 for D4 and channel 5 for D5. Now their frequency should not merge. That's why in between we are providing the guard band. Guard band means we are giving some space. So that space which we are giving between these channels, that is called the guard band. So everywhere we are giving some certain space. So these are the space given in all the channels so that they can carry. So this is called the guard band. And guard band is of 10 kilohertz, we are assuming. So now we can see that if there are three different devices, and four, five devices are there. So we can say that 100 kilohertz for first device, 100 for second device, 100 for next, then 100, then 100. So 500 kilohertz of the frequency, plus we are having the guard band which we have provided. So the guard band which we have taken is of 10. So 10 plus 10 plus 10 plus 10. Now these all sum, that is equal to 540. So here we can see that this 100 plus this 10 hertz plus this 100 plus then again this 10 plus this 100 and again plus this 10. 10 is the guard band frequency, which is the unused. Again this 100 plus this one guard band plus. So that combined total is equal to 540. So that means the link which is carrying the data should be 540 kilohertz. So this is called the guard band. Now guard band meaning is that, let us suppose that we are having different channels. Now these channels are having some gap is there because their signals could not merge together. This is called the guard band. So we can say that channels are separated by strips of unused bandwidth, guard band, to prevent signal from overlapping. So the guard band is very much simple. As through this diagram, we have seen that if there are five devices which are sending the data of 100 kilohertz, then these five devices are having five channels into a link, means through cable, one wire, five channels are there, and these five channels are separated by some gap, and that gap is called the guard band. So that is the guard band. Now talking about the example of frequency division multiplexing. So the example of frequency division multiplexing is three narrow streets which are merging to the three lane highway. So if the three small streets are there, and these three streets are combined together to a three lane highway. So that is the example of FDM. That means three roads are merging to a three lane highway. That means 10 plus 10 plus 10 is the capacity. Then 30 will be the capacity of one complete highway. So this is all about the frequency division multiplexing.